H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Quality Center, Addings, and under this you have Microsoft Office add-ins, which contains MS Excel add-in. So you click on that and you need to download the add-in. Okay, so do you see here? We have the Microsoft 9.2 add-in and then we have the 9.0 add-in. And do you see here very clearly it is mentioned the versions supported. For the 9.0 version of your Quality Center, you should have the Microsoft Excel 2000, 2003, XP and 2007. But on your computer, it is Windows 7 that is installed, and also if you check the Excel type, it is 2010 starter version, or you know, you have the OpenOffice, right? So all those are not compatible with your Quality Center. You should have the full version of Microsoft Excel 2007, 2003, then only you can work with this add-in. Okay, so you just have to download and install it. It takes just few minutes, and after that you should install one more add-in, which I'm going to show you. So this is the first add-in. So again, click on the add-ins page, and then you have the Mercury Quality Center connectivity add-in. Click on the download add-in and then install it. Okay, so here also same thing, Mercury Quality Center add-in page, and under this you have the connectivity add-in. So these are the two installations that you are supposed to do. Okay, these are the two installations. Now let's see the steps. The steps are going to be very simple. So I have the Excel sheet here. After you install both the add-ins, then you come to your Excel sheet, click on the add-ins, you can see export to Quality Center here. Okay. So once you have done the installation of the add-ins, you come to your Excel sheet and then go to the add-ins tab, you can see here export to Quality Center button will be available. And here we have written, can you tell me what kind of document it is? Is it a requirement? Is it a defect? It is a test case. What kind of document it is? Yes, it is a test case document that we will try to. It is Karishma test case document. Do you see step, expected result? So go to the add-ins, then click on the export Quality Center after selecting the rows that you want to export. Okay, and you should make sure that the test case document is compatible to the format of your Quality Center. For example, the step and then expected result, because we do not have the test data over here. But here we have the priority reviewed level. So you make sure that it is compatible with your Quality Center. Now when I click here add-ins and then export to Quality Center, the steps start. There are exactly 8 steps over here. Okay. So what is the first step? Enter the Quality Center server that you would like to log in. So I enter this URL. Can you tell me where have you seen this URL? while you are logging into the Quality Center Explorer, QC Explorer, yes, it is the same URL. So can you tell me what will be the next step then? If I click on the next button, what will be the next step? What it will ask? User ID and password? Okay. Click on the next button. Do you see here? Username and password. You already know what is the username and password. Username is alex_qc. Password is blank. Next. Domain name and then you have the project name. Right? So you know the domain is default. Project name is qualitycenter_demo. Third step. Are you following everybody? Okay, then I click on the next button. Here it is giving me three options. What document I want to export? Do I want to export the requirements? Do I want to export the test? Or I want to export the defects? Can you tell me which one should I select? Test, the second one, because we are required to export the test case document, not the requirements and then the defect. Then click on the next button here and then we should create a map. I'll tell you what exactly is a map. You will be able to understand it yourself. I'll create a new map over here called as store locator. Then next. Already exist. Overwrite. Yes. So do you see this is nothing but mapping. Which column of the Excel sheet should go into what field of the quality center? Okay. For example, here these are appearing in the red and that is because these are required fields. I select the subject, click on this arrow mark. Can you tell me in the subject I should write which column? Column A, B, C, D, which column should be going into the quality center? Which column of your Excel sheet should go to the subject field of the quality center? It is A, right? Verizon Wireless, do you see the name of the project? So we write here A and then OK. So whatever you have entered here in this first line, it will get entered into the subject. Test name. Yes, it's B. Okay. What about the level? C. Priority? D. Reviewed? It's E. So this is nothing but we call it as a map. Which column of the Excel sheet to what field of the quality center. Now I want the step number here, which is nothing but your step name, I will say. This is F. Description. Which column? Description. G. The last one that is expected. Which column? H. Is it difficult? You're done. Okay, this much only. Just click on the next button. It will export it. Finish. Do you see? Exporting. Please wait. Completed. Then finish. Now we will go to our quality center and check if it has appeared over there. So go to the quality center explorer and then QC bin. Click on the go button. Authenticate. Login. go to the test plan and check. Verizon Wireless is appearing. Is it appearing? Yes, do you see? Here it is. Click on the store locator. Do you see the design steps? These are the same that were present in our Excel sheet. Correct? Okay. Now the next question is, I hope these steps and everything is fine. So you have to do the installation of the two add-ins. And then you have the steps to be followed. Okay. Manisha, for requirement also it is the same thing. See, for the requirement, you should first of all create the Excel sheet for the requirements. And after you create the Excel sheet for the requirements, you should follow again the same steps. Instead of selecting the test case, you select the requirement and fill out the or do the mapping. Click on the next button. It will automatically get exported. Okay. Now, can you tell me what is the purpose of doing this? Okay, I have listed down your answers over here, some of your answers, okay, which are relevant, and these are the purposes, okay. So if you have already done it in the Excel sheet, let's say you are trying to implement the quality center in the mid of the project, that time you can use this export. If it is not possible to get the license for all the testers or let's say all the team members due to the budget constraints, so we can create in the Excel and then export it to the quality center. Maybe that all the testers are not able to access the quality center at same time, so we can write it in the Excel and then export it. So these could be some of the reasons why we may are trying to, why we may be able to use the Excel along with the quality center. Okay. It is one of the feature that is available. Now this is going to be the last session of your quality center, and after this session, that is from tomorrow, we will be starting with the tool that is called as the Toad for Data Analyst. Okay. And what I will do is I will be sending you the link here now in the chat box. Make sure you download from there and also double click and install the tool. Rekha, I have sent you the quality center recordings, but if you want the installation recordings, you need to please check it with our technical team. Okay. Okay, give me one moment, everybody. So I'm going to give you the link here. In the chat box, all of you please click on that link and then you can download and install it. In the next session, if you are not able to install, I will help you. Okay. Now I think we are left with Reena and one more, I'm not sure who. Okay, Reena, I will make you the presenter. You can please tell me what is your question. Okay. Yes, Reena. Please tell me what is your question.
Hi, I just wanted to show you. I've never shown any of my assignments before. So if I can show you my quality center, the requirements, if they are correct, if there's anything that needs to be corrected. And also, since you said I cannot do different requirements in test plan, which I was not aware of linking the test, so I'll make sure the next assignment I'll do, you know, everything same.
Okay, show me your requirements. So valid, invalid, blank, and then same country under the currency converter. Okay, this is fine. Any other you want to share?
And also, if there is no error, if there's no defect, and we end our step on, I'll show you. So this is the test design, I'll show you then. Created subparameters also. I could not do the call test on preconditions. I was not able to do it.
Show me why you're not able to do it. Click on that.
Okay. If I click on this, and then, oh my god, I forgot where's the link.
Beside that pin symbol?
Here? Yes. Oh, yeah. Okay.
And so then, you should uncheck that checkbox which is in the bottom first of all. Show only the template
okay.
Test.
Okay.
And then you
okay,
select
got it.
Yes, then you can select the test case.
The store locator and then click OK.
Yes.
What
okay,
does
so
this
what
mean?
You're trying to do is you're trying to call the store locator in the store locator again, which will give you the error.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Okay.
So I should do it on this one then.
No, whichever you do, it is again the same test case, right? You are only changing the step. The test case is same.
Okay, so I can
do
it.
No, you cannot do it. You have to call a different test case, not the same test case.
Okay. Okay. And since there was no fault, there was no defect, I ended with that. I'll show you. Hold on. What was the next step? Give me a second. I was on this step, right? Okay. Okay, execution grid. Execution flow. Oh, this is just store locator to store locator. Was it correct? This is what I wanted
yes,
to know.
Because
there's only one
test
case.
Right.
Okay. All right. So I just wanted to make sure that. Mm-hmm. And there's no defects on that. So I could not really.
Okay. Try to create some defect, okay? And then you try to do the practice of linking.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you, Priya.
Yes, you're welcome. Okay, Shilpa, I'm making you the presenter and then you can quickly share your question with us.
Can you hear me, Priya?
Yes.
Yeah, in this Bombino Express, we are doing for the home page and currency converter, everything we are linking and doing it as when we go for the run. So when I'm doing the currency converter and run here, when I say begin run, so I have to execute all these things again, home page, quick user tools,
yes,
and all these
you
stuff.
Should.
So for every run when we add test cases, we have to do that, I mean separately?
Yes, you have to do that, otherwise you should not add them. Okay.
But these are the things that we do when we check these things, right? The home page load, the quick
yes,
user tools.
Right. So it should have already executed, maybe you have executed in this test case or in the previous, that's okay. In the previous test run if you have implemented, that also is fine.
Okay, but still we have to write and just say, instead of, I mean, doing it again, we can just say it as passed, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I have that question, because whenever I write the test cases, I'm getting the same things. I have written for the currency converter page load, so I did the same steps, and for again this one, I'm getting the same steps. I was just confused to write it for every test case or just the one in the starting and just continue with that. Okay. Thank you.
Okay then. Yeah, so we will be closing the session here. Tomorrow we will meet at the same time, 7 o'clock. And tomorrow the class is going to be up to 8 p.m. only. Okay? Okay then. Thanks everybody. Have a good night and make sure, you know, you install the code for data analyst with all the default options. Do not change anything. Do not enter anything. Just accept the license and do the installation. Okay? Okay then. Take care everybody and have a good night.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.